Hi, I'm Nicky Bleiel, DocTo Help's lead information developer. Welcome to this edition of the DocTo Help video tutorial series. Today we are going to take a look at a typical DocTo Help workflow. The basic DocTo Help workflow is three steps. Step one, create a DocTo Help project. Step two, add documents. With DocTo Help, you can import documents you already have, begin with no content, or do both. And step three, choose and build the target. That's it. You can make all sorts of customizations, big and small, but that's the core. Let's try it out. Click the Getting Started Wizard button and work through the wizard. If you have existing documents, you can import them into your project using the wizard. Or you can create new XHTML documents. Those are edited in DocTo Help's built-in editor, a new Microsoft Word document, or a new HTML document. Once your project is created, you could add other documents, or you can create new ones. Step one and step two are out of the way. That was fast. Now step three. Let's choose and build a target. We'll build NetHelp, DocTo Help's browser-based output, first. We'll choose NetHelp from the Select Target dropdown. You'll notice that there are 10 different output options. Then we click the Build button. Before we take a look, let's examine what we've done. DocTo Help has automatically created a logical table of contents, and since this document included index entries, an index. Now let's take a look at our NetHelp. DocTo Help created topics, as well as automatic links to subtopics, automatic links to glossary definitions, and it includes search. In manuals, DocTo Help created the front and back matter, the front cover and table of contents. It converted links to cross-references and added footers. How does DocTo Help create topics? By analyzing the heading styles in your documents and breaking your content into topics based on those styles. No matter what type of source documents you have, they will not be changed by DocTo Help. But any changes you make to the documents will be incorporated into your outputs the next time you build your project. The power of DocTo Help is that you could stop here if you wish. You now have professional outputs that can be distributed on the web, desktop, or on mobile devices. But if you want to customize further, it's easy to do. For example, you could customize the skin of your outputs by customizing the theme. You can change the default styles. You can create and insert reusable chunks of content called variables and apply conditions to exclude content from specific outputs and versions. Variables and conditions are great for single sourcing online help and manuals from the same project. You could add links to other topics and create additional index entries. In addition, you could customize the table of contents. There are many more customizations, but as you can see, with DocTo Help, you can create usable outputs in three steps and customize them as much as you want to or need to. Head to DocTo Help.com to download your free trial of DocTo Help. I'm Nicky Bleiel. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing Component 1.